Hi math friends, welcome back to our series of math games. This time we're going to, those of you who played horse race with me during the last session, we're going to continue with horse race, but now we're going to change it up and we're going to play fraction horse race. You'll see you have a game board for this as well. Those of you who didn't watch the last video, I shared these dice trays that I am using to play these games. There is a link underneath this game where you can go online and you can actually purchase one of these dice trays for your house, as well as a book called Stratadice, which has a bunch of different games in it that you can play at home using this particular dice tray. So if you play games with your kids, this is a great purchase, one that I think you will thoroughly enjoy. It comes from the company Boxcars and One-Eyed Jacks. However, if you want to play this game and you don't have one of these dice trays, I'm going to show you how you can just do it with dice at your home with the game board that you can download. On that game board, you will also have the directions at the bottom to remind you how to play. But hopefully this video will help you with that. If you do purchase one of these dice trays, you don't want to just lift the clear lid off and dump all these dice because they'll go flying all over the place. So instead, what we do is we have kids hold it in their hand like they're serving in a restaurant. They take their other hand, they do an alligator chomp and a pancake flip. And when you do that, it turns it upside down so that you can lift this black lid off, and it will make it a lot easier for you to be able to get your horses out of that clear lid. And our horses being our dice. Megan, do you want to be the white horses or the blue horses?
I'll be blue.
She's going to be blue again. That's usually what happens. So I'm going to let her take all of her horses out of the blue side, and I'm going to take all my white horses out over here on this side. Now, for this one, we're going to still use this black tray as our racetrack, and our clear lid is going to be on our barn. But what I'm going to do is line this up on here so that you can see how the tray matches up to the game board that I gave you. You can see on the game board how it has the fraction lines on there for you. You don't have that on the racetrack, but that is underneath if you do want to be able to look at that. So what we're going to do for this one, we have our barn will be resting up here for us. We're each going to take two of our horses and race them just like we did before. So we corral our horses in our hands, we put them down, we take a peek. What we're going to do this time is now we're going to take those two and we're going to put them to make a fraction that is less than or equal to one. So we have to make a fraction that is less than or equal to one. So my number is 2/4.
I have 1/6.
Now what we have to do is we have to compare 2/4 and 1/6. So we still want to use that comparison vocabulary. I also gave you a download which has the fraction strips on it. Now at your house, I would print this off and I would have you have your child color these. So you might want to color your whole red, color your halves blue, color your thirds yellow, color your fourths green, color your fifths purple, and color your sixths gray. That way the color coding will help them see those different size units. They can use this to help them compare. So I had 2/4, so I have to find my 2/4. Megan had
1/6.
So she's going to find her 1/6 over here. And now we have to compare our 2/4 and our 1/6. So I can see 2/4 is greater than 1/6. And Megan, you would say?
1/6 is less than 2/4.
And now what we want to do, it's the person who has the smaller fraction gets to put their horses on the racetrack. So Megan would put her 1/6 on there like that. My 2/4 go over into the barn. We're going to pick up two more horses. Ooh, I have 5/5, which makes one.
I have 3/6.
5/5 is greater than 3/6.
3/6 is smaller than 5/5.
So my 5/5 go into the barn and her 3/6 go onto the racetrack. You can see how she's putting them onto the racetrack, so we can still see that fraction 3/6. Here we can see that fraction 1/6. We're gonna race again. I don't have much luck when I play Megan in games. Oh my goodness. I have 3/3.
I have 1/6.
3/3 is greater than 1/6.
1/6 is less than 3/3.
So mine go back into the barn and hers go back onto the racetrack. All right. 2/5
and three-thirds.
Two-fifths is less than three-thirds.
Three-thirds is greater than two-fifths.
So my two-fifths come over here on my side of the racetrack. Four-fourths.
One-third.
Four-fourths is greater than one-third.
One-third is less than four-fourths.
Mine go into the barn. Hers are going to round the corner. When she rounds the corner, you can still see that it shows one-third. One-sixth.
Four-fourths.
One-sixth is less than four-fourths.
Four-fourths is greater than one-sixth.
So my one-sixth goes on my racetrack. Hers goes into the barn. Two-thirds. Now I'm going to have Megan change hers for just a second and change hers to two-thirds. Yep. So I have two-thirds.
And I have two-thirds.
Since we have two-thirds and two-thirds, this time when we have a tie, we are going to go where it says both players. And we're going to put them side by side in the middle. So yours would come down here so we can see two-thirds and two-thirds. Now, let's do another one. Let's roll. Keep your one-half right here. And I'm going to say I had three-sixths. So if I roll three-sixths and Megan rolls one-half, when we use our chart here, we can see three-sixths and one-half. We can see that those are equivalent fractions. Same thing as a tie. With those equivalent fractions, we're going to put those side by side so we can see three-sixths and one-half. So when you have a tie or when you have equivalent fractions, both players are going to put those side by side here in the center. So where you have your player one, your player two, those are for your individual winners. And then your ones that you tie, you put on there. So I think we have one last set to roll here. I have 1/6.
And I have 4/4.
1/6 is less than 4/4.
4/4 is greater than 1/6.
So my 1/6 goes on the racetrack. Her 4/4 goes into the barn. Megan obviously won this one. Again, it's the person who has the most horses on the racetrack is the winner. And clearly we can see that Megan won this one. Actually, not by as many as we originally thought, because I did kind of catch up. Now, we can turn the racetrack again so that we could switch color horses and we can play. Now, if you don't have one of these racetracks at home, as I said in the earlier horse race game, what you can do in this case, you just need four dice. And if you have four dice, each person just rolls their two. Makes their fraction, one-third,
two-fifths,
and we can take our chart out, find one-third, find two-fifths. I can see that one-third is less than two-fifths.
And two-fifths is greater than one-third.
So I would, over here on my side, I would write one-third. Megan would not record hers because hers was the greater fraction. So now we would just roll again. One-sixth.
And
so I 1/6 is less than 1/2, and Megan would say
1/2 is greater than 1/6.
So you can just use the recording sheet. So we would roll again. 4/5
and 4/4.
4/5 is less than 4/4.
4/4 is greater than 4/5.
So my 4/5 would go on here. So you can use the recording sheet having to use the dice tray if you don't have that dice tray at home and have your students record on that. Again, you have your directions down here at the bottom of your recording sheet. As I shared with friends earlier, if you have a sheet protector at home, sheet protectors make great dry erase boards because you can put that page right inside of there, and that way you don't have to continue to make multiple copies of all these game boards that you have been downloading. You can see mine are a little bit bigger. Sometimes you can find these at Dollar Tree, and you can just stack all of your different game boards inside of here, and then you can have kids put whichever game that you're playing right now right here on top. So just kind of an easy little tip for ways to keep track of all these game boards at your house. I hope you enjoy playing Fraction Horse Race. It is a lot of fun, especially for those in grades 3, 4, and 5 who are working on comparing fractions. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment underneath the post and we'll be happy to answer them for you. Have fun playing.